Hello, I'm EnterElysium and welcome from the depths. Okay, so this is the finalized-ish Wing Zero class. As you can see, we've got like missiles behind the hind deck. We've got a laser anti-missile system. We've got 10 torpedoes. All the nice juicy stuff that you really could expect from a Wing Zero class. It's got like lots and lots of speed. It goes over 20 meters per second, which is kind of insane, frankly, and I'm very, very happy about. It's got a reasonable turn circle with all those thrusters. Let me just check that you are set up correctly. No, you are not. There we go. And as you can see, you can't see any blue here. That's because I had to widen it. The reason I had to widen it is it was a submarine. Yeah. Quite simple. It went to the deepest, darkest depths of the ocean and then just never came back up. So I had to add, as you can see, like right ahead, you can see that I've got a line and a line. I had to add a layer of light metal alloy, which is actually incredibly buoyant. Really, really buoyant to the side to try and keep it out of the water and not, you know, underwater, because that would have been bad. As you can see, some of the metal at the back has been replaced with light metal alloy as well. So, this entire thing clocks in at... What are you clocking at? 1 million resource points. Almost 200,000 metal. But I think it's going to have a significant amount of firepower. Now, the laser anti missile system, I've reduced to one emitter. That one emitter fires a AP3 150 damage beam at a range of 1.5 clicks. And it fires 8 times per second. So I think that should be enough to destroy any incoming missiles, or unless they like significantly swarm us. That should destroy the vast majority. What I've also done is, because I don't know who we're going up against next, I've planned for the eventuality it could be someone with lasers. And because of that, you'll notice that we have Laser Warner. AI with a load of attachment blocks. Smoke, 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 smoke. If we go up the front, you'll see the same thing. There we go. Smoke, 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 laser warner. And here, smoke and laser warner. There we go, again. So, what will happen is, I think smoke lasts for a minute and then takes another 2 minutes to recharge, if I recall correctly. So what it does is it detects a incoming laser doing damage, and it goes, okay, I will deploy smoke. Then, for 60 seconds, I won't activate, and then I can deploy smoke again. And the other one down here can deploy 3 smokes at once. Let me go find you. Where is the actual warner? Here we go. There we go. 3 smokes at once. So what it should do is have a rolling smoke cloud. Smoke. Smoke disappears. Smoke. Smoke disappears. Smoke. Smoke disappears. Back to the first smoke. And what happens is the entire thing gets covered in smoke. And smoke cuts down the damage lasers do, or like significantly removes it. Like, we should be fine. I've also added shields all over the place. Very heavily shielded. You can see vaguely the outline of shields there. A little bit removed from the hull so that any explosive rounds don't do splash damage to the hull, or at least don't do very much. And I think... Oh, other than mentioning the fact that we've got repair... There we go. These are our repair bots here in the rear. We've got a load of them on deck. We've got some in the front. If I find them. There we go. And here. And here. And we've also got 10 repair tentacles. So the repair tentacles aren't there to just be OP and repair other ships nearby. They're so that I can repair, like, out of play. And I think, yes, we also have some EMP blocks just to try and negate any EMP that gets fired at us. Not a lot of them, but there should be enough there that if we get attacked with an EMP charge, it'll at least disrupt some of the EMP. Which will otherwise take out all of our important systems, like our AI. I'd say the Wing Zero is a pretty good ship. Now, one thing that I have noticed that I haven't really been messing around with, and thus need to be messing around with at some point, is the charger overclock, which allows you to scale the charge rate up. So what happens is, if you go to 10, you take 10 times as much power, but your charge speed goes up by root 10. So we're getting approximately a 3.3 times speed increase to our charge rate, which means that this thing can now charge much faster than it can draw ammo. It draws ammo and it cools down about 7 seconds. Its charge rate used to be about 7 seconds. Its charge rate is now about 2.5? Yeah. So we can get this thing firing about 3 times faster with a lot of effort, because what we'll need to do is we'll need to increase the speed at which shells are put into the breach, which means at least 2 more autoloaders, probably. Or improve the one we've got. Probably a better plan. We will need... What else do we need? What else do we need? We need cooldown. So we need a load of cooling units. And then it'll be faster firing. Now, I could just change it so that I have more of these spinning rails. I don't like calling them railguns, because it's not really a railgun. It's very different from a railgun. A railgun has 2 rails and they don't spin. But whatever. But that would just give the projectile more force. And I don't actually need more force on the projectile. What I need is the projectile to be fired more, you know, more repetitively. Bam, 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 rather than bam. 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 I would much rather have a fast-firing projectile. 3 times faster? 3 times the DPS. Yes. So I'm going to do this, but I'm going to do it off-camera, because it's going to involve a lot of tinkering to try and get it into this form factor, because we never built it to really actually have a 3 times faster firing rate. I never expected the firing rate to be able to go up to 3 seconds-ish. But we'll give it a try. Now, what you might have been wondering is, what is this gigantic thing in the background? This, my friends, is going to be our fortress resource gathering thing. So I went ahead and I did a lot of the designing off camera, as you can see, because I didn't know what I wanted for the shape. What I came down to in the end is, I was like, right, I want something looks a bit like a, is it the Demiurge from 40k? That they're not really mentioned anymore. But I want something vaguely long, with lots of guns down the front. Couple of lasers, some laser missile defense, that can have a load of resource gatherers in the bottom. So loads of resource gatherers here, and you can just go suck up all the resources, be very large, and then it can also have, you know, cannons coming all the way back inside to be able to fire ridiculous shells at ridiculous ranges. Up the top, we'll have a few rail guns and flat guns to be anti-air stuff. We've got missiles, as you can see, we've got lovely missiles here. We'll need some torpedoes as well to take out any subs that happen to appear. So we'll have some sort of drop torpedo system that drops ballast zero torpedoes so that they can, you know, go down and also go up. We could also have a super cavitation gun that can, you know, fire underwater. But I don't really see the point in that, really. If you're going to have a gun, have a gun. If you want to go underwater, probably best to go with the torpedoes. I mean, the gun will be good, but the super cavitation module really does make the shots kind of crappy. So be like, oh, excellent, against the one enemy that you very rarely get, the submarine, you can injure it. But against everyone else, yeah, you kind of sucky. So I don't really see the point in that. I can see it occasionally being useful, but not really on this one. Underwater cannon that can fire super cavitation projectiles out of the water, that's great, because every time it's going to be going through water. But not in a niche case scenario, where you're sort of hamstringing the rest of your guns. So what we're going to do today is we're going to talk about the actual weapons we're going to be putting in, and we're going to put in some crazy cannons. Now, unfortunately, I wanted to use 8-meter-long shells. I wanted to have the ridiculous, the max-size gun you could get. But they aren't in yet. They are in the beta, but they're not even working in the beta version. The dev test version, the actual, like, block is in, the 8-meter autoloader and 8-meter clip. But they don't work. They haven't been coded to be 8-meter-long. They're actually 4-meter-long in the code, so they just don't work. So instead, we're going to be building a slightly subpar cannon. I mean, I say subpar, it's not going to be subpar. It's going to be 0.5-meter sort of diameter shells, which are 4 meters long. But it's not going to be, you know, the max size possible. Because, you know, the reason I wanted to build a max size is because I can build a max size, not because it's optimal. Basically, like a YOLO reason. Like, I can, I will. Is that the max, Yeah, there we go. Shell diameter, 0.5 meters. So we've got our max diameter shell here. Oh, yeah, that looks good. That looks good. Right. We need to figure out where the autoloads are going to go. I'm tempted to put them up. Yeah, so let's also get the gauge cooling unit out. That's fine. And then I can put autoloader here. So if you go to autoloader, 8-meter. You're not working, are you? I could swear you're not. clip. I really wish clips and autoloaders were in the same section, so autoloaders here, clips here, just so I didn't have to keep flipping between these two. It is somewhat annoying. Right. We're going to have to make the shell half the length. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I want an AP capped head. 88 second to pass it to clip, 44 to reload from clip. Cooldown time of 2 minutes. Yeah, we're going to need to adjust some of these things. Anyway, let's get a... ooh, supercantation base. Blah, 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 blah. Boring. I would like visible tracer, only good for fast firing. Flak warhead, less explosiveness, but bigger, like, AoE. Gravity compensator. As a force down, where possible, to simulate the gravity strength of the firing altitude at higher altitudes. This helps maintain accuracy when firing on high... the gravity compensator adds force down, where possible, to simulate the gravity strength of the firing slash aiming altitude at all higher altitudes. I have no idea what gravity compensator means. Oh, right. So if you aim it really up, normally the shell will go to space, and it will be like, okay, now I'm screwed, and it can't aim properly because it gets into this odd gravity area. Whereas this will now be like, okay, I'm still in gravity. And it, yeah, okay, that must be what it does. Smoke warhead, deploy smoke. I don't really need to see what the great use in that would be, unless you're just firing, like, really close to the ship. But you'd have to be firing constantly. Let's get HE body. HE body. HE body. So what have we got? Muzzle velocity of 3... 5-7, that's pretty good. Explosive damage, pretty good. Cooldown time, less than the ammo clip time. Might be a little bit much. An arm pierce isn't very high. That doesn't really change much. Yeah, I think we're going to need to go with something like... I don't really want to go down to that sort of speed. Maybe if we go with... ooh. Maybe a base bleeder would be great in this circumstance. Because it doesn't increase cooldown as much. That looks good. 311, I like that. 20 meter explosive radius. So that's like a 40 meter diameter. That's crazy. 3,423. We'll need to decrease that at least by half. Okay, I'm liking it. I'm liking it. Okay, I approve. Right, let's get out of there. And, woohoo! Hello! We have one shell. I wish when you prefabbed it worked with the mirror line. That'd be absolutely lovely. If we could have that change. I beg you, Nick, please. Please. Please, Nick. Give prefabs. Right, and then if we... that should give us a pretty crazy fire rate. Now, of course, I'm going to need to wait for these to actually load up, which is the downside. And I also need a few more of these guys. 1, 2... oops, I forgot my mirror line. And I can link up over here as well. Excellent. Everything is taken. We've got 2 left. And I'm going to just wait for shells to be loaded, because this is going to take a little bit of time. And the only real way to find out the firing speed is going to be to wait. So I'll be back with you shortly. Okay, so we can see that we actually have a load of shells now. And they actually go at 3 in a clip, which results in one being completely outside the clip. But... okay. Everything is fully loaded except for this very last one here. 0.5 times faster due to multiple clip inputs. 0.5 times faster. 0.5 times faster. 0.5 times faster. In theory, this should fire pretty fast. Inaccuracy. Really? Inaccuracy of over one? That's not acceptable. That's just not acceptable. No. What's the optimal barrel length for burn? 24. Okay, let's increase the length of the barrel. So the barrel we have at the moment is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then at the end, I would like an advanced cannon, barrel, bore evacuator, much reduction in cooldown time. Inaccuracy of 0.12. Now that is good. This should give us a pretty powerful shell. So, where am I? I'm over here. I would like to go and fire the gun. I'm pressing a 12, speed of 630. Oh, is it because this is the wrong shell? Wow, that was a loud gun with a deep booming echo. I like it. Cooldown time, almost 40 seconds. That's fine. We know what we got to work on. Cooldown time. Cooldown time is where it's at. It reloaded pretty fast. Is it reloaded? Yes. That's better. That's the shell I was looking for. Okay, arm piercing a fire. Kinetic damage. Explosive damage. Okay. Cooldown of 20. There we go. 22.27. That's more what I was expecting. However, it's still cooling down. Now remember, this is like pinpoint precision, right? 4 kilometers, and I wasn't even aiming for distance. This thing will be able to shoot probably 12 kilometers. It's going to be limited by space. And yeah, I think we've hit space now. It will come down, but very, very gradually. Maybe it won't. Nope, there we go, we've hit space. You can see that the speed's just stopped. Okay, so let's try firing it a little bit flatter. That looks good. What range are we getting? I think we can only engage for about 5 kilometers. Any more than 5 kilometers, it's going to go to space, which means I'd need to put on the gravity compensator module. Which would mean I'd need to get rid of something else. This makes me sad. Oh, that's still fairly respectable. And we're firing pretty often. Now, the cooldown is technically slightly longer than how often we're firing. But it's not enough to make me want to change anything. We've got the max firing speed we can. Our firing speed is maxed. Unless I add more autoloaders. And I think we have enough. Let's just be completely honest. This is probably enough autoloaders. So I don't want to add any more. I don't think we need any more. So this is not a king cannon, because it isn't, 8-meter autoloaders, which are coming. But I'd say it's certainly a queen cannon. This thing is going to have ridiculous amount of punch. Now, if we just add... I need to go build mode. Mirror line. Advanced. Full predictor. Okay. And if I was to happen to spawn a ship out here, say, load vehicle, built in, neater, where is the Marauder? Marauder. My team, load it. Up a bit, up a bit, up a bit. Let's go have a look at that. Not as much damage as I was expecting, but it has ruined the back. You can see it's all, like, messing around and stuff. There's a whole load that's been lost, but that's because it hit the paddle wheel bit. So let's try and hit the hull. I'm going to try and clip the hull over the side there. Still the paddle wheel bit. Okay, at least we've destroyed part of the paddle wheel, because that paddle wheel is getting... Oh, it's turning. It's turning. Yes. Come on. Maybe the cooldown does need to be improved. Taking huge chunks out, but not as huge as I was expecting. I'll be honest, maybe it does need improvement to the round. Maybe we could adjust the round in some way. And if we then spawn in, say, something made of metal. Onyx Watch. Bastion. Where are we? Where are we? We're here. Right. I'm trying to figure out our firing arc. Come on. Drop the shell up. Okay, let's go inspect the damage. Now, actually, that is fairly impressive. That is actually fairly impressive. I was expecting a lot less after seeing the damage to wood, but against metal, that is a big hole. Now, the problem is with this ship is it does repair pretty quick, which is great for testing against. It's also terrible, terrible, terrible if you're trying to kill it. Seriously, it's impossible to take out with railguns because it just keeps repairing itself. Where the hell are we? Oh, we're there. That's why I haven't found us. Sorry. And fill with water. I'm reloaded. Promise the bloody cooldown time. Yeah, certainly. We could be firing so much faster. The DPS, we could get double. And a double on a cannon like this would be pretty good. Okay, I'm going to go have a little bit of inspection then. I feel that is actually acceptable. Against wood, it isn't quite as good, but against metal, it really excels. Now look how fast they rebuild this ship, by the way. That's insanity. I can't even tell the amount of damage because they just keep repairing so fast. It's kind of frustrating. But I do feel that this is acceptable. I mean, there are several things I'd like to do to shell. Penetration fuse would be great, but it takes an entire HE section, which means, you know, decreased payload. Still might almost be worth it. I feel the accuracy is immensely awesome, like 0.12 is great. What else? I mean, if we went for penetration fuse, we need more penetration, which we don't have, so yeah, we can't really do that because we need to change the penetration. I feel we're fine. Maybe a little bit less gunpowder because it can't go that far anyway. Maybe a gravity compensator would give us insane range. We'd need a gravity compensator though, which we just don't have. But I've been EnterElysium. We're going to end it there for today. I know we've just been focusing on this one cannon, but There's so much to advanced cannons that I am spending quite a lot of time on each video. We will get faster and faster, and I'm going to build the railgun for the anti-air defense on here, off-screen. I'll also alter this railgun, because we've done railguns before. So I'm going to alter this to have overcharge, and I'll build railguns here, probably with overcharge inbuilt, and just be like, boof, boof, boof. Just firing tiny projectiles, just to take out ships and stuff, like insane speeds. But I've been at EnterElysium. I'm also going to try and replicate this cannon maybe a couple more times with the space I have available, so we've got a few of them. These ones on the end are going to be a different design, probably some sort of multi-barrel design, with a maybe short barrel and faster fire rate. And then on top, flak, etc. Flak I'll do on camera because it's going to be new, and a couple of other things, and then I think we're going to be done. I'm going to try and limit it to just one more building episode, and then we're going to go and take on whoever it is. So, one more building episode. I do think that maybe more than four would be pushing it a little bit, but, you know, something like a fortress like this is going to take time, but I don't know how much of it is actually really going to be new for you. So we'll see. We'll see. It might be two, but it won't be any more than two. I'm going to try and make it one. But anyway, I've been here. If you like, please like. Not subscribe, please consider subscribing. I am liking this cannon. I will change the fire, the cooldown time, though, because, my God, the cooldown time needs to be slashed massively. Because we could be getting a cooldown time, a reload time of about 12 seconds. We're on 22 at the moment. So, inaccuracy, 0.57. Okay, so inaccuracy is actually slightly higher. Okay, fine. But yeah, until next time, stay shiny.